Hi everyone and welcome to this SQL tutorial video. In this video, we're going to learn how to download and import AdventureWorks database in SQL. For some of you who are not sure what is an AdventureWorks database, simplest term, it is a sample database provided by Microsoft. So in order to download the backup file, you can go to directly to the Microsoft page and get these files downloaded. I will link this description in this video. And so when you scroll at the bottom, you would be able to select the database based on your SQL Server. And in this case, I'm going to install AdventureWorks 2019. So I'm going to install it OLTP file. If you have data warehouse, you can go and install that, or lightweight, you can go and install that. So in this case, I'm going to install the online transaction processing database, which is also known as OLTP. So once your file is downloaded, you can place that anywhere as long as you are able to locate that when you are restoring the database. You would then be required to connect to your SQL Server Management Studio. I have this open on the background. So to connect, I will connect to my instance. And in this case, I will connect to my Express Edition, which I installed. And if you'd like to know how to install SQL Server 2019, I will link that in the description below or in the suggestion box. You can view that. Click on connect to connect to your instance. And then what you can do is you can quickly go ahead and create a database. In order to create a database, I will right click on the database and I'll select new database. And so I will give a name to this database. I would keep it the same. And I will click on OK. You can go over here and change the log part, but I'll leave this to default. And I will click on OK. And my database will get created. Now, in order to import my database, I will right click on this, go to task and select restore database. From this, I will need to select the source of where my database is actually placed. So I will select device. I will click on this in order to search for my device. And I'll click add. And so by default, it takes you to the backup of your Microsoft. However, like I said, you can place that link to whichever folder you prefer. I have placed that link in my D drive. So what I'll do is I'll open it. I'll just copy the link over here, minimize my screen, go over here and paste the link, and you will be able to find that file. I'll click on OK to proceed. Okay. And my backup file gets added. I'll click on verify backup media to check if everything is okay. And as you can see, my backup media has been successfully verified. Now, once I have done my verification of my backup media, I can go to options over here. I will select override the existing database. So if there's any tables that I have, it will just override and it will replace it. So I'll just ensure I do that and then I will click on OK. And it will start to backup my media. Once the backup has been successfully completed, you'll get this notification and you'll click on OK. And you'll notice that you won't be able to see anything over here. But if you go to the particular database and if you open the tables, you should be able to see all the tables over here. And at this point in time, if your backup has any issues or if it was not successfully restored, you would not be able to view all the tables in the database over here. So as you can see, you should be able to view all the tables. And if you want, you can go ahead and write a simple query to check if you are able to read or view the tables or not. And so what I will do is I'll just use this table to run it for all the employees, human resources employees. Okay, and I'll click on execute in order to run my query. And as you can see, I am able to run and get the entire data. So I hope you have enjoyed watching this video. If so, please do give a thumbs up and consider subscribing to this channel.